These wetlands, these creeks, the lake, they all worked perfectly. Fire came through, rain fell, filled up. They found the perfect niche with which to develop. And it's only after development came in and people came in, we stopped the fires coming through, we built houses and built roads and fragmented these areas, and that system was interrupted.
A restoration project at Deer Lake State Park plants carnivorous flowers to help snowy plovers. While the two species don't interact, they are connected through fire and water.
So we are on Camp Creek Lake. This is a globally rare and imperiled coastal dune lake, one of 15 that you can find here in Walton County. In order to be a coastal dune lake, they have to occur within, I think it's a mile or less from the coastline. I mean, you can find coastal dune lakes in various places throughout the world, but what makes ours unique here in Walton County, Florida, is the periodic opening to the Gulf.
To help the lake's watershed, they're restoring pine uplands, where tie-tie had taken over the forest and the wet prairie around it.
So, this area was cleared in 2011, and prior to that, it looked much like this closed canopy tie-tie in the background, the tallest trees being 30 feet tall.
Historically, however,
we probably would have experienced some shrub-like growth like this mixed with herbaceous grasses and the target plants that we're trying to reestablish, which are carnivorous plants like pitcher plants, butterworts, sundews, and also several species of orchids. In the Florida Park Service, there were a lot of records from early on of pitcher plants and other bog plants and orchids that when those sites were revisited, we couldn't find those plants. It was probably the result of a lack of fire in the landscape that was allowing these areas to get shaded out.
Funding to restore these bogs comes from the Gulf Environmental Benefit Fund, which distributes settlement money from the 2010 BP oil spill. While Walton County wasn't heavily damaged by the spill, the Gulf's overall snowy plover population was, and the plovers are tied to the pitcher plants.
The outlets of the coastal dune lakes are very important to shorebird nesting, in particular snowy plovers, and the Gulf population of those snowy plovers is significantly depressed. The blending of the fresh and salt water at the outlets provides the forage that's necessary to fledge the young of the snowy plovers.
Here's how the uplands connect with the coast in four steps.
You're looking at an area that was recently burned. It was burned within the last 3 weeks. Atlanta Botanical Garden, in conjunction with the Florida Park Service, we burn these parcels here at Deer Lake on a 3 to 5 year rotation. One of the things we were trying to do on this project, we were trying to introduce fire back into these areas that have been cleared that haven't had fire in as much as 70 or 80 years.
When you have this hardwood replacement that fire doesn't move through, it builds up a layer of litter, which year after year, litter, and we had decades of fire exclusion here. So you tend to build up a layer of litter, which decomposes into duff. And in the uplands, all of the litter that comes from all the plants and a lot of the pine straw and such is burned up on a regular basis. Another thing that happens in this sort of forest of tie-tie is a lot of the water that would be percolating out, hitting this stream, and moving towards the Gulf of Mexico is actually absorbed by the roots of the tie-tie and it's transpired right back into the atmosphere. So we actually lose a lot of water from this.
This was initially cleared in January of 2016. This is a remnant wet prairie. This was tie-tie all the way out to the edge, so everywhere you see where there's flags, both behind me and on down, was thick tie-tie, 30-foot high trees that had been cut out, chipped, and removed off the site. This area, as far back as 1941, was open and grassy. There was no trees. It was just open herbaceous. it's an aerial photography, so you can't see what's on the ground, but we know that the signature was herbaceous. So it's an area that water has flowed out of the uplands, flows near the surface, and stays mostly saturated for the most part with low nutrients and allows these beautiful plants to thrive down here.
Individually, the snowy plover and the pitcher plant are remarkable life forms, but they're also part of a larger system. Restoring that system to working order is satisfying work for John and Jeff.
Extremely satisfying to know the work that is going on here is advancing and making these areas better. I mean, to watch new plants come up, you know, every growing season, or watch flowers and see them where you've never seen them before, it's wonderful, very, very satisfying.
For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.